In this video, I'm going to set up I3WM for my Manjaro KDE. Now I open up the web browser. At the address bar, I type in github.com/farukphuket/desktop-i3, then hit enter. Note that the link will be at the description down below. So when you click on the link at below description, it's going to take you to this page. Now what I'm doing is I click on the code here and then I click and copy this link, or you can download as zip if you want to, but for me I prefer terminalware. Now I open up terminal. That will be console if you're using KDE. In the terminal I type in git clone and then I pass the URL and then I hit enter, so it will clone the configuration for me. Now when I type in ls, you see that I have desktop i3 right here. Let's type in cd and desktop i3 cd into that. Now type in ls. I assume that right now use desktop, or if you use laptop you go into this folder. Now let me test this. Let's cd in laptop. And then what I'm going to do now, I'll type in ./ and setup .hs, and then now I hit enter. It's going to do a thing for me. What it's doing now is going to clone the wallpapers from the GitLab. The wallpaper size is about 14 megabyte. It's 100 pictures in it, so it's gonna take time. Now it's going to ask for the password because we need the root permission to install thing. So this setup will install i3 and some required program that we have to install in order to use I3WM. So this window just pop up. This one is called CMUS. It's the best music player ever for me. So I like this program very much. Now if you want to quit that, you press Q and then Y. It's going to quit. Now you might need to put another term for your password. It's going to change shells for you. So it's going to change from bash to CSS. Now it seems like thing is already done, and the whole process it took me like 15 minutes for that. Now we have to log out. Let's go log out. Now this time before you put the password in here for login, I want you to take a look at the bottom left here. Make sure that you click on that and you select i3. Now you put the password in here and then you hit enter to log in. So if this showing up for you, it means your config is already success now. But what happened if I'm going to reboot, it will log in as the KDE session. Let's try that. Now I'm going to reboot by press mod key 0 and followed by R. Now it's going to reboot my system. Sometime in the vision box is taking too much time for the reload, so you have to do a reset again. If it's taking too long, now you see that my system is start up again, but you know that we log in as the KDE session. What you can tell now is something is changed here. You can see that our prompts is changing if compared to the earlier time. But what to do if I want to directly log in as the i3 session? I don't want to log out and select i3 on every reboot. So this is what I'm going to do. Click at the start menu right here and file setting, file system setting. At the left bar here, you click on the startup and shutdown. What we're interested in is the behavior here. But before that, I need these two. So I click on this and then I click on the apply because I want my login window is look different than the earlier. Now click on the behavior and then right here as user, you click here. Make sure that is select as Farouk or your username right here with session i3. Make sure this one is i3 select. Now thing is done. Click apply and then put the password in. Make sure this remain the same. All right, now let's try again. Oh, I close that and let's reboot. Now my system is start up again, and you see that this time I'm logged in as the i3 section that I want to. What if I want to change the wallpaper? Well, you press mod key D and you type in nitrogen, hit enter. It's going to open up this program right here. It's called nitrogen. Next thing what you're going to do is you click on the preference and click on the add button. Remember that we just download the wallpaper at the very first time that we run the command. Now the wallpaper will be in pictures and wallpapers. Now you select that and then click OK. It's going to list it out for you. So I want this wallpaper. I click on this and then I want to make sure that I select zoom fill and then click on the apply. Now to close this window, you press mod key shift Q. Now you get the wallpaper. All right, that's how you do it.